This is the second video for 08246 that's going to be looking at the second lamb task. So we just click and open the sheet for the second lamb task, and as it says here, we're going to create the SQL site. So if we first need to create the database, so we look to see if we've got the Microsoft SQL Management Studio, because it says there's two ways of doing it, one with the Management Studio and one with Visual Studio. Go through all of the things, so let's look for SQL. Here we are. We've launched Microsoft SQL. So let's go back to the notes. So we select a database engine, and then we want that server name, which we can paste in there. Windows authentication, and we can set up our username and so on. So let's connect. And then it says we should get a screen like this. We expand the database node on the left hand side, so let's do that. Let's shrink this down here so that we can see the two things together. And you can see, I can actually see everybody's database. So I can choose, as it says here. Now right click on your database, and there it is. That's me. And it's the tables. So it says to begin with, there's no tables in the database, so I need to create one. So we can import a data file. So we download the crime CSV from the website and save it somewhere. So let's go to the VLE. The labs button. So then it says we want to download this CSV file, so we can save that, and I'm going to put it in a temp folder. Now right click on your SQL Management Studio and select Tasks Import Data. I should be able to right click on here, Tasks Import Data, Data Source, this a flat file. File name of type CSV, crime, open it. So the text, let's move that over here. As it says here, we want the text qualifier to be a double quote. Pick up the column names. Then we want to go to advanced. And then we want to change the data type for each one of these. So it's a 4-byte assigned integer. Says we want all except false. Change the data type. And then it says you can click through next, and if you keep going through, you should eventually be able to get success, 423 rows transferred, close. So then we can go down, and once it's complete, we should be able to look under our system tables. And here it says once the data is import, we should be able to see the database table. But it does say if you don't see the table, right click and select refresh. So we could point at tables, we could right click and do refresh. And there, when we look, we can now see the crime table. And if we look in columns, we can now see the same set of columns as shown here. And I can widen that a little bit. And you can see the columns are the same, we've imported the table. And we can use the SQL Management Studio to explore the data. So we could try right clicking on the crime table and select top 1,000 rows. Here we are. See some information there. So as it says, that's written an SQL query for us, which has achieved that. And we could modify the query. And it says that's also useful for testing queries that you're later going to be using in your PHP scripts. Okay, so that's the end of making and beginning the querying of an SQL database. The next section is about creating it using Visual Studio, just in case you don't have the Microsoft SQL Management Studio. So I'm not going to show that in this video, but all the details are there for those of you who need to do it. The next section is a reminder what has to be done for the coursework. This is work not shown in the video that you do for your assessment. So you now have to use one of these database creation techniques to create a small database to store information about a user and their location and some time and date of when the information was changed, so that you could use that to link to the enquiry scripts that you're going to write. So the next video will look at doing all of this in PHP and creating server-side in PHP instead of handwriting a server.